of the major challenge earlier I had was that the major back pain, when you gain a weight, I have a tendency, maybe, you know, similar like me, may have other people have it. The moment you start gaining weight, you will have a pain related to that. So I started developing my back pain and all. And that's the early telltale sign that tells you that, you know, you ought to do something for yourself. Otherwise, it keep aggravating over the period of time, right? So for that, actually, I decided that, you know, my first aim to be weight reducing. Second thing would be, you know, at least my back pain should go away. And with this help of this exercises and all, I really see that, you know, yeah, definitely there was a 4 kg loss in my weight. But that weight loss also contributed to my back pain completely vanished. So now I'm like almost 9 to 10 months without a single back pain day. So I never had to use any spray or things like, you know, utilities to get my back straight and all. And I don't feel like, you know, fatigue when joining the exercise. It's like, you know, otherwise it, you will see some sort of, you know, joints are getting, you know, tied up when you do a lot of exercises and all. And that never happened in this regiment of exercises. I mean, it was pretty smoothly done. I never feel like, okay, I'm like, you know, I'm done with my this week. I'm not able to get up, or I'm my whole body's paining, or my leg is paining, specifically part where I have focused more on my exercises, or my hands are paining. I didn't see that complaint. I never ever had any complaint about that. So with the wonderful instructors and all, that can be very well handled. Instead of, you know, I remember my old days when I hit a gym and, you know, I run for something, I do some exercises and all. After a week time, I have to literally be on my bed, or at least on my chair, to get my muscle relaxed, or do some ointment, apply some sprays on all to get my muscle relaxed, and then I can join it. But here it was pretty smooth transitions, which I can feel it, and it was a really complimentary thing to go for it. From a second or third weeks, I started feeling the changes in my body. It was more like, you know, the first major sign of giving me is that, you know, I see the weight is getting reduced. Second thing is that, you know, you're trying to gain your muscle flexibility. Your body is now becoming, you know, instead of fatigue, you will say that, no, I'm getting my stamina back. And that was a, you know, I mean, turning point for me to, you know, realize that, no, this is something is definitely working out for me. It's not like that kind of exercise. The exercise which the trainers are giving is very well, you know, or very well oriented and very well focusing on your pain points. I was able to cover almost 3 kilometers within the span of 18 or 19 minutes, even not hitting the 20 minute timeline. So which was like, you know, it opens up my eyes, saying that, okay, yeah, earlier it was like, you know, after panting and a lot of running, I was able to complete 2 kilometers within the 16 minutes of time. And that too, sometimes I have to take a break in between to get my breath catch up on that thing. But it's all like, you know, I can run constantly on 9, even though after 20th minute, I don't feel much of, you know, tiredness or, you know, urge to stop my my treadmill and, you know, wait for it. So that is something I feel is a huge, you know, improvement, or I would say that, you know, it is a part of my overall stamina that has been increased so far.
Hello everyone, this is Payas Bhardwaj, founder of Gympansy.com, and we have one of our clients who have achieved some amazing transformation after joining the 12 weeks lean body program. Mr. Nirav Joshi is here with us. So you know, I want to hear from your side, like, you know, how are you, when did you join this program, and what all, you know, challenges you were facing before joining this, and what changes have you seen with this program? So yeah, you can go ahead and get started.
Yeah. All right. Thank you for introducing me. Hi everyone. My name is Nirav Joshi. I'm a working professional. I got to know about Chimpanzee from a web advertisement, and during the pandemic time, actually, I was looking forward with some sort of, you know, home gymming and with some motivations and all, and I kind of, you know, thought, you know, give a chance to Chimpanzee, and I started my journey somewhere in the April month. My first goal was to, you know, first of all, you know, a pandemic hit everyone's and our life was very standstill. We all live in the home, eat and all. There is a very less part of our body goes for an exercise and all. So I don't want it to be continuing in that paradigm of so-called as, you know, pandemic and keep continuing that. I wanted to improve upon it. And this was a great opportunity, what Chimpanzee was at that time delivering it, a home solution-based exercise and all. So I thought of, you know, give a chance on that and, you know, try to see that whether does it work out or not. And I started this things to, my first aim was to, you know, accomplish the weight stability. I mean, reducing is my goal first, but first thing is that after reducing, your weight should be stable, right? It should not be keep increasing or decreasing. Your food intake was kind of, you know, stable. You do your exercises, you burn your calories and all. So that routine I was not in, and I was desperately looking forward with that sort of a routine. And with that mindset in my mind, I was, you know, keen on, you know, starting on the this exercising, you know, campaign and all together. And it started with the April months. Initially, it was a combination of, you know, regular sessions with the trainer itself and one every day 1 hour, and followed by that. It was like, you know, app based also, where you can do it at your own pace, with your own convenience, not regularly, like, you know, you have to do it in the morning. So that gives you the, you know, ability to flex your timings, do your workout at your own will, own time, which gives you the great flexibility. The second point is also instructor, which I have been through, and, you know, those who I was dealing with them, they are very well matured, well, you know, very well knowledgeable. I would say that they are the domain expert or the subject matter expert of this whole body tuning part. And the transformation, as Pius has asked about me, the transformations which I felt was not, I have to wait for 3-4 weeks. From a second or third weeks, I started feeling the changes in my body. It was more like, you know, the first major sign of giving me is that, you know, I see the weight is getting reduced. Second thing is that, you know, you're trying to gain your muscle flexibility. Your body is now becoming, you know, instead of fatigue, you will say that, no, I'm getting my stamina back. And that was a, you know, I mean, turning point for me to, you know, realize that, no, this is something is definitely working out for me. And I would really look forward into that direction. So that gives me a motivation. And to be very honest, something changes in your body and you wanted to pursue for it to keep happening, keep your body more like, you know, flexible, more adjustable to your, you know, I mean, adjustable in the sense that, you know, you should be flexible at the time. You should be, you know, any kind of a cardio or any kind of a combination of exercise should not be giving you fatigue, or, you know, you kind of, you know, oh, I have done overdoing in 1 minute or 2 minutes of time. Now I'm done with the whole exercise regime or not. It's not like that kind of exercise. The exercise which the trainers are giving is very well, you know, very well oriented and very well focusing on your pain points. So it's more like, you know, the routine start with your, you know, basic stretch out sessions, then extensively the hyper workout session, then it cools down period, then if you tend to do a yoga or meditations, your choice, you can dive into those sessions. So it's not after the 1 hour I'll be like, you know, completely panting and, you know, I'm completely exhausted. It's like, you know, after I my exercise, I'm kind of, you know, still at the same stage where, you know, I will feel like energetic and, you know, start my day with the full energy, even though I have done 1 hour exercise session. That doesn't actually, you know, give me a fatigue. So, which is a wonderful thing, the way the exercise regime has been, you know, defined, and the steps and the, you know, way we do the exercises and all. And trust me, you don't need a kind of, you know, heavy gym equipment or anything. It's just with the help of even dumbbells, or if you don't have a dumbbells, which works fine. And which is a very good thing about it. It doesn't focus on the materialistic thing. It's focus on your body, and which gives you, you know, the and this is can be done at anywhere now, no matter whether you are in your home or whether you are anywhere. If you are traveling also, maybe you can plan your day and put 1 hour forward it, and you can do it anywhere. So that's the most important and very nice part of this exercise. So I don't need to hit the gym. I don't need to hit any kind of, you know, specialized room, specialized equipment, nothing like that. You can be anywhere, provided you have internet and mobile or laptop, whatever is communicating things with you, and you can start your routine. So this, I mean, And that's what I feel about whole program on this, my journey.
Amazing. Right. So another thing, like I was, just talking to you today only on phone call, and you were explaining me about the flexibility part is also something which you were looking after, and it's overall, sure. Stamina improvement. So can you share something about that as well?
Certainly, sure. So before I joined this program, I was also doing my own exercises. I have a treadmill at home. I was doing pre-pandemic times, I was doing gymming also regularly 1 hour. But that time my stamina was somewhere between, if I quote my stamina is like, if I have to run on my treadmill with the speed of, 9 or 8, depending upon this, I would hardly cover within the 15 minutes, or after 16 minutes, I would cover 2 kilometers. So that was my, standard stamina. I was running from 2 to 3 years like that only. But after, I kind of, joined the sessions, and then I do it every alternative day. So we have a gap of 1 day between one of our routine exercise versus 1 day gap. So in that gap, I always trying to, test my abilities or test my, how much my stamina is. So I thought of, starting my, regular running exercise on my treadmill, and I see a significant difference. I was able to cover almost 3 kilometers within the span of 18 or 19 minutes, even not hitting the 20 minute timeline. So which was like, it opens up my eyes, saying that, okay, yeah, earlier it was like, after panting and a lot of running, I was able to complete 2 kilometers within the 16 minutes of time. And that too, sometimes I have to take a break in between to get my breath catch up on that thing. But it's all like, I can run constantly on 9, even though after 20th minute, I don't feel much of, tiredness or, urge to stop my my treadmill and, wait for it. So that is something I feel is a huge, improvement, or I would say that, it is a part of my overall stamina that has been increased so far. And also there is not only the running stamina, but there is also the picking of the dumbbells also. So after 10th or after earlier time, after 10, after 7 or 8 kind of, push-ups and all, I was like, I can't lift it anymore. So I was like, I wanted to put down my dumbbells. But this one is like, I can go till 11 or 12 at least. I mean, it's not a huge in increment, but it is definitely about 10 also. So that is, again, I would say that, with the regular doing an exercise on this program and all, gives me a muscle strength and, build my muscles in such a way that, it doesn't kind of, fall apart, or, say that, no, you are done with that, or, I can only take up till 5 and all. So that's a huge improvement, I would say, in myself. And definitely, yes, I would also add one more point on that it's not only that focus is on a weight. I also focused on the weight first. And that also gives one of the major challenge earlier I had was that the major back pain, when you gain a weight, I have a tendency, maybe, similar like me, may have other people have it. The moment you start gaining weight, you will have a pain related to that. So I started developing my back pain and all. And that's the early telltale sign that tells you that, you ought to do something for yourself. Otherwise, it keep aggravating over the period of time, right? So for that, actually, I decided that, my first aim to be weight reducing. Second thing would be, at least my back pain should go away. And with this help of this exercises and all, I really see that, definitely there was a 4 kg loss in my weight. But that weight loss also contributed to my back pain completely vanished. So now I'm like almost 9 to 10 months without a single back pain day. So I never had to use any spray or things like, utilities to get my back straight and all. And I don't feel like, fatigue when joining the exercise. It's like, otherwise you will see some sort of, joints are getting, tied up when you do a lot of exercises and all. And that never happened in this regiment of exercises. I mean, it was pretty smoothly done. I never feel like, okay, I'm like, I'm done with my this week. I'm not able to get up, or I'm my whole body's paining, or my leg is paining, specifically part where I have focused more on my exercises, or my hands are paining. I didn't see that complaint. I never ever had any complaint about that. So with the wonderful instructors and all, that can be very well handled. instead of, you know, I remember my old days when I hit a gym and, you know, I run for something, I do some exercises and all. After a week time, I have to literally be on my bed or at least on my chair to get my muscle relaxed, or do some ointment, apply some sprays on all to get my muscle relaxed, and then I can join it. But here it was pretty smooth transitions, which I can feel it, and it was a really complimentary thing to go for it.
Right, amazing. Okay, so one more thing which I, you know, mostly people ask me when they tried getting into the program is, Pius, like, you know, we can do all these things at gym also. So what different are you providing inside the program that, you know, that's pretty much different from other programs and what we have already experienced? So can you give some feedback on that part as well? Like, what do you feel? Yeah.
Sure. So I guess, you know, I have a right experience to give you an answer on that. The reason is I can just build you a context for that one. Before I joined Gympanzee, I was earlier doing pre-pandemic time. I was hitting regularly gym. I had also kind of a dedicated instructor who was instructing me on that front and all. So that was purely on the exercise basis. So the focus of the gym was more onto the, you know, hey, you have to reduce your weight. Second thing, you have to build your muscles so that, you know, your weight converts into your muscle weights, and muscle weights are built up, then you can, you know, go with the steady approach. The second thing is that what was happening is that I was only focused with the intense level of exercises, intense in the sense that you have to do a cardio, you have to do weightlifting, you have to do, you know, your leg exercise, this exercise. So it was like, you know, at least more than one hour. I was spending around 1 hour and 30 minutes in gym to do all these exercises. Now I can see that, you know, and I need to do all this using the equipment. So equipments like, you know, your chest puller, your shoulder press, all this are doing is using equipment. So when I have to, let's say I'm away or I cannot attend gym or I am some remote locations, that time it was very difficult to, you know, envisage that exercise. How will you do it? Maybe you may have a few dumbbells, or maybe you are at home and you are, you know, you don't want to go to the gym. How you can anticipate those things? So that gives us a, you know, by doing this exercise, it gives us a holistic new view, saying that, you know, without gym also, you can maintain very well your body, maintain this, maintain your, you know, muscles, maintain your, you know, strength and all those things without needing of that complex equipment and all. So that barrier has been really removed from this one, and which I feel, you know, that gives an advantage in this kind of an era where, you know, people avoid traveling, maybe, you know, travel to gym also takes time and all these things, which I can productively use these hours into on my home to do these exercises, right? So it's a win-win situation for me if I tell you that, you know, going to gym and doing this exercise versus doing here in front of the instructor. And not every time gym instructor may be, you know, helicoptering you every time, right? That whether you are doing right or not, sometimes you have to be on your own to do that. But here it's like, you know, you get 100% attention because you are in front of the camera. If you're doing wrong, they will immediately tell you that, you know, hey, this is something that you are doing wrong. You should improve it, or you should not. Let's say at a given point of time, I was doing my dumbbell exercises and I'm like releasing the dumbbell. I was like, no, pretty fast, then next, pretty fast, then next. So when I kind of, you know, indulge into those exercises here, I came to know that, you know, you don't have to release your body so fast or release the muscles so fast. Otherwise, it doesn't have much of effect. So you have to go steadily, slowly like this, release it slowly, pick up slowly. So that way you will be, you know, in tandem with the exercise things which you wanted to do it. And it affects exactly your points. And they tells in the instructor also tells that, you know, see, it is affecting you this side, affecting your collarbone, affecting your this side. So all this, whatever you do, it's not like just he tells you and you how to do it. It's more like you can say that why we are doing this, what is the significance of this exercise. And there will be a proper explanation that why we are doing it. It's not just sake of doing it, saying that, hey, this is what is there in the app, or this is what we have to do it. And instructor are pretty dynamic here. So if you think that you are doing very good with the regular exercise routines, let's say 3 sets or 4 repetitions and all, they give you a variety of variation in that. So sometimes the variation could be a good variation where you will be feeling like, oh no, I am burning so much of calorie. It's not like a regular thing. Okay, I have done it. Maybe you are good at doing these things repetitively, right? But when the variation comes, you may see that, you know, how flexible you are, or what's the best way that they are trying to they are trying to get the best out of you, right? So variation, the variation and the understanding of every single exercise, which what part it intend for, what is the impact if you do it, what is it's going to be long term, it's helping you out, and all that gives a very much good knowledge. So today, if I'm knowing that what is the lateral, what is the collarbone exercise, what is the shrug exercise, I knew that part now. And with the proper knowledge, I mean, I'm not saying that, you know, I can be, you know, 100%, but when doing with the gym, it's like, you know, you have to do this, you have to do that, you have to do this. So it's more like, you know, I can feel the difference here. And to be very honest, trust me, the gyms are still open. I don't feel an urge to go there and, you know, do that exercise to, you know, regain the old kind of my timeline or my time period. I feel like, you know, continuing this will also give you more productivity and more benefits over the period of time, because the variations, the instructor and all, and you do it together, right? So you may have a team or you may have a people joining with you. So it's like, you know, it's not like that, you know, it's a chaos there where instructor cannot focus on you there is a 10 people in the team or it cannot be focused on all. It is pretty focused approach, even though you have multiple people still. They focus with you. They go in sync with you. It's not like that, you know, hey, you are doing slowly, others are doing fast, and you will be omitted, or you are kind of, you know, left behind, and then people move on to the next exercise. They will go with the tandem and all. So that's a good thing. I mean, in kind of, you know, chaos exercises, this is most important things to go ahead with.
Right. Okay. And one last thing, like, we were also talking about the diet part, right?
Right.
So I would like to know about what your diet strategy was,
sure.
Like what you were doing before and what you are doing now in terms of the nutrition and diet.
So from that perspective, I would say that this whole exercise regime do come with their diet plans and all. So many people, you know, not like me, but I would say many people do follow the diet plan and all, which gives an immense benefit out of it. Now, I would, if you ask me, Nirav, do you follow the 100% diet plan? So I would, to be very honest answer, I would give say that no, I can't follow the 100%, but I took some best out of it. Let's say the eating the nuts in the morning, or let's say try to avoid the intake of your carbs during the night and all. So I kind of, you know, restrict my few things according to that, and I would not say that the diet plan is completely goes into the vein. It is as useful as it is if you can follow it 100%, which is a wonderful thing. But sometimes due to the, you know, our things or our busy life and all, we can't get the right amount of things. So it's as per mentioned in that one, right? So we have to sometimes go with this, sometimes we have a holiday, sometimes festivals and all. So my approach I try to follow it, but sometimes it was not happening regularly with me. So I said that I will take the best out of this diet plan. I will go with my regular food instead of, you know, making that one, but I will be more conscious on what I eat, what I don't eat, my intake is, whether if I am having a more sugary intake or more carbs intake, I should burn it, or all these things. It's a back off in my mind, the saying that I have to manage it. I mean, regressively or very much like, you know, daily, I have to be very stringent routine. No, if you give a time, go ahead and follow it up. So I would say that, you know, in that context, even though you don't able to follow your strict diet plan, take the best out of it. Do whichever you can follow it. So like, you know, eating nuts can be easy things done. Eating vegetables can be easy things done. Few things when you get a chance, try to accommodate your diet plan in it. When you don't get, don't try to hell bend on it saying, no, it should be like this only. Try to be moderate on that. And, you know, you can change in something other. So it's like balancing the weight between two things, right? If you eat carbs, you have to burn that carbs in the other day around and manage it. So by doing this balance activity, the kind of gives me more, you know, agility. So I would say that, you know, I don't have a fatigue. I don't much of, you know, having a laziness or procrastination saying that, okay, I'm going to do it later on or something like this is my, like, you know, Saturday, Sunday should be my relaxed time. I feel like, you know, same Saturday, Sundays also can be, you know, you can utilize it and do the exercise. So that is the most important part about my diet plan. And it's working fine till date. I mean, with the consciousness in your mind saying that what you eat and how you feel about it. And second thing is that you have your conscience to burn it away if you think that, you know, you have done a lot of carbs and all, and I would not say we can completely avoid it, and we should be completely restraining or restricting ourselves, but we should do it in the moderate fashion, which will be, you know, complementing in this exercise routine.
Great. All right. So now coming, we are, you know, almost done with this whole video testimonial part. And I would really like to thank you on, you know, whatever feedback you have given about the program and what challenges and how you were able to overcome that. Now, one last thing, like before ending this testimonial part, mm-hmm. I would like to know, like, you know, what advice can you give to people, those who are watching the video and, you know, those who really want to start, but something is stopping them. You know, whether it is, you know, I keep, you know, if I enter into the program, how can I do this, that, how I'll be managing my daily schedule, then how I'm going to, you know, follow the diet and everything. So what advice you can give to someone who wants to get started with this program?
Okay. So my very first advice, I would say that, you know, see, if you are planning to enroll this program, don't think twice. I think it's a fairly a wonderful decision, because you are taking it for your own health. Health is a wealth. And trust me, in this era, it is most important things, right? Now, the second part is this one, where, you know, if you are in the middle of saying that, you know, I'm going to do it my own way of exercises, even I'm more self-motivated and I also tend to do my own exercises. But what happens sometimes, we are slaved by our mind saying, no, today's a very cold day. Today we are lazy. Today we worked late night. I don't want to wake up today to do my exercises and all. But the most important part, what happens here, when you enroll for something, you have a they keep motivating you. So it's more like, you know, even though I work a little late and morning wake up time is very much difficult for me, but still I will at least try to make it out for this one. So now let me just complete and give 1 hour for your dedicated to yourself only. So take that 1 hour in your life from your day, not in your life, but from your day. Cancel all these things. If you have anything, be it a morning or evening, I don't bother about it, where you do or where you work or how you work, but give 1 hour to yourself and see that the transformation comes in your way. Give this dedication to yourself and try to dedicatedly do it very, you know, meticulously, so that, you know, it's not like that you're doing for someone else. You're doing for your own body, on your body, soul, and your heart and your mental health, right? Because if those are all aligned, you will be doing much more greater things. I would not say that, you know, you will be immensely Superman, but yeah, you will be better human being. You will be better at many, many things, which you can, you know, which you may be thinking in your future and all. So that gives you, you know, that I would say that, you know, if you are thinking or you are saying that, no, I'm doing my own exercises at my own rate. Trust me, I was also doing my own exercises after I left my gym due to the COVID and all. But it was not much of, you know, in motivation, or it's not like, you know, I have done 10 sets. Okay, let me relax it for some time. Sometimes I switch over to my mobile. Sometimes mobile takes 15 minutes of time up. I have a complete gap after that one exercise. So this gives you, you know, a complete 1 hour session gives you a variety of exercises. It's just not only the burning of your calories. It's giving you the calmness of your mind, or, you know, peaceful upness of your mind also at the end, which I follow by the, you know, meditation things. And you never know, meditation, I have never done it in my life, but I feel like it is very important things after I'm starting it doing here. So you never know which things works out for you. We, until or unless we never tried it, we never come to know about it, right? So I would say that try it, at least challenge yourself, get pumped up, and, you know, wake up at that time and see that, you know, transformation will be definitely there.
Right. Okay. And talking about the age, like, you know, most people, when they join the program, they think that I'm almost 35, I'm 40. Mm-hmm. You know, how can I do this? So can you tell people, like, what's your age and, you know, how many hours of job or whatever you do, you are right now? What's your schedule and how you were able to manage?
Sure. So if I talk about myself, I'm 37 year old. I work as a professional in one of the IT company. And my schedule is, I mean, all ITs are, IT peoples are working from home. The schedules are very, you know, spread across the day or even in the night also. I don't blame it, but yeah, this is what we have to embrace it right now. So to be very honest, I would say that I'm not a morning person where I wake up at 6 o'clock and join anything, but the timings and all things can be managed. And I would say that, you know, my day starts a little late because I work with different clients in my other geographical region. So, you know, I have to do some sort of an overlapping. I'm not a regular 9-to-5 guys. So for me, it's like, you know, challenging getting up in the morning is one of more challenge. Second thing is that after getting up challenge, you have to make yourself available for, you know, exercise, right? It's not like that. You just wake up and come directly to the exercises. Your body will not start working on that front. So you have to crank up your body. You have to make yourself available. Okay, now I'm ready to do my exercises and all. And you have to give it your 100% to do that, right? So with this kind of a lifestyle, I would say that, you know, the better time management, you can do it because you don't have to go anywhere. You don't have to drive. You don't have to bring equipment. You don't have to do anything. You just get your room, get inside your room, do your 1 hour sessions, come back out of it. And that's a wonderful feeling. You can get it after anything, right? Be it morning or be it night, I do not see any challenges. Or if you feel like, you know, I would say that 1 hour, you know, once in a day, 1 hour is more than enough to, you know, get you started. And then if you feel, you know, you are more energetic, you can do it twice in a day. It's completely up to you. But being a working professional, I would not say that, you know, this is, you know, kind of, you know, you have to manage a little bit of time and, you know, you can come out of it. You can do your things and all. So that's what I can tell as a working professional. I would say that, you know, the working hours may be different for me, for others and all, but that can be very well adjustable. It's not a hard routine here in this exercise regime that, you know, you will be only entitled to do it in the morning and all. So that's a wonderful thing. There is a flexibility. There is a, you know, they try to, you know, go according to your timing so you don't miss upon anything, so or you don't have to, you know, miss the golden period, because after 10 or 11 it doesn't much make a sense to do the exercises. So you can do in your golden period of time, whether it is in the morning or if you're an evening person, you can do it in the evening time as well. So before food or after before your dinner or before your lunch or before your breakfast, you can wrap it up your session. So that's a wonderful thing, which I would say that, you know, for a working professional, it is easy to manage and, you know, cope up with the timing. So that's what my suggestions would be here.
Right. Great. So I think we are, you know, end of the whole video testimonial. And I think you have fairly, you know, given your honest review on what you have felt about the program and, you know, what you want to, you know, convey to others. Like if they really want to get started with the program or even if they want to do things on their own. So it's, you know, just if you really want to get started, put in some time and then you are going to, you know, achieve your targets, whichever you would like to achieve. Right. So, okay. Thank you so much for, you know, giving your testimonial, Mr. Nirav.
Yeah. Thank you, Paras, for bringing me into this one. Happy to spread the health and awareness. So
and I'm really happy that you are, you know, still continuing your journey with us and achieving, you know, your goals.
It's kind of now for me, it's an addiction. So I would say that, you know, it keeps me going and all, instead of, you know, burning fuel, going to gym and all, even though my gym membership is still pending, but I feel like, you know, this will be more healthier approach rather than, you know, hitting the gym. So you never know which one makes you more comfortable and all, and gives you peace of mind, right? You don't have to go anywhere. You can just do it within the home itself. So, I mean, I'm not much of an introvert person, but I would say that this gives you the, you know, lot of time savings and all, and gives you the flexibility of your home.
Right. Great. So, all right. So I'll see you, you know, in tomorrow's day after tomorrow's session, Tuesday sessions and all.
Sure.
Thank you so much for giving this testimonial. Yeah.
You're welcome, Prayas, and all the best for all of you. All right. Stay safe. Cheers. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.